VH500, audiophile grade 500 watt power amplifier monoblock. Features: fully integrated audio solution, rugged construction, balanced inputs, thermal protection, overcurrent protection, sound optimized soft clipping, suitable for CE approved designs, electromagnetic compatibility certified, safety certified. Specifications: 450 watts before clipping for all bandwidth at 4 ohms in bridged connection, 550 watts at clipping level, 3 ohm load compatible in bridged connection, 121 dB dynamic range, total harmonic distortions plus noise 0.002% at 1 watt, 86.4% total efficiency, intermodulation distortion 0.0009% at 10 watt, measured for frequencies 18.5 kHz and 1 kHz. Preamplifier total harmonic distortion 0.0001%. Preamplifier common mode rejection ratio 91 dB. Balanced input impedance 1 mega ohm. And selectable mains for 110 and 220 volts countries. Amplifier design: lightweight aluminum enclosure providing excellent heat dispatch. High density plastic speaker connectors with 5 mm copper center wire. We found that such type of connectors are widely used in professional equipment as backup connectors for acoustic system connection. The plastic connectors significantly reduce the risks of short circuits. A standard tested mains connectors widely used in all industries. The balanced input connector is selected with a rigid cast aluminum housing and key for operation in high vibration conditions. Removable feet for flexible mounting options. Proven manufacturer latest generation amplifier board. Height 60 mm. Width 180 mm. And depth 160 mm. And weight only 725 grams. Inside the VH500. ICEpower125ASX2 board is one of the best ICEpower Class D amplifier modules in the world, even today. ICEpower is Bang & Olufsen engineering spin-off company which specializing in the production of Class D amplifiers. It is one of the leading manufacturers of high-quality Class D amplifiers while continuing to develop and improve its product line. The sound of these amplifiers is amazing. Pay attention to the mounting density of the amplifier. Practically there is no free space visible on the board. Seems that multi-layered printed circuit board is used. Smallest size SMD components are everywhere. As a result, dimensions of the power unit are unusually compact. When taking a closer look to ICEpower125ASX2, we can see that kilowatt-capable components has been used providing extra reliability headroom working at 500 power range. For example, output stage switching MOSFET transistors are 34 amps capable. Balanced preamplifier. The preamplifier is a critical good power amplifier component with high impact to sound quality, often neglected by the designers. Our design uses the latest generation Texas Instruments INA1650 chip. The most important symmetrical input components are integrated in the chip and made by single lithography process. Those achieve component accuracy of 0.05%, which is not possible in the case of discrete designs. As a result, incredibly good in-phase signal attenuation values are achieved. Common mode rejection ratio is 91 dB or 35,000 times. Total harmonic distortions are minus 120 dB or 0.0001%. Preamplifier parameters are so good that we can simply neglect them. There are no negative impact to sound quality at any usage scenarios, even connecting them in series of 10 units and more. Preamplifier perfectly matches the line signal with the power block and forms the signal required for the bridged connection. Package. The packaging is eco-friendly, without gluing and plastic laminated coating. The package contains a power cord and an amplifier. Package is printed with high-quality visuals. Optimum placement. A typical scenario is when the amplifier is placed on acoustic system or glued to it with double side tape. In this case, the connection cable from the amplifier to acoustic system is short, approximately 50 cm. There is no need for high-quality large cross-section speaker connection cables and B-wiring. We can safely glue amplifier with a cover side without worrying about the covering ventilation openings, as the vertical position forming the chimney and amplifier will cool perfectly. For those who feel the vibration of acoustic systems affects the sound quality, I can confirm that it is not affected by semiconductor technology. Most of today's modern recording studio control monitors are with a built-in amplifier and with a confidence serves as a measuring instrument during recording process. But if you don't believe it all, place the amplifier on the floor near the speaker system. A little bit about offerings. The Hero product is a stereo bundle consisting of two VH500 monoblocks, two high-quality 6-meter-long microphone cables with XLR connectors, and adapter cable for RCA connection. Just monoblock and single package is available as well. And for those who want to assemble, build and screw by themselves, whether everything seems expensive, we offer an amplifier housing with a preamplifier, connectors, and internal wiring, but without ICEpower power amplifier board. Those boards are available on eBay and some retailers as well. So far, I didn't find any clone. All modules what I did purchase in eBay, even from China resellers, were genuine. So, to make things clear, we are selling DI kit without main power cord, retail package, power amp, and warranties. But for a good price, you will get significant savings and risks as well. Honestly, I don't see too many risks because Preamp Unique has passed production tests and ICEpower125ASX2 has proven record being in the market for several years. Waiting for a miracle. Nevertheless, audio amplifiers have been in market for many decades, people still waiting for a miracle, thinking that I will buy new units similar to previous and tremendous improvement will happen. In our days, manufacturers learn how to make good amplifiers and most of the commonly available 100-watt amplifiers from proven manufacturers has comparable quality. The key differentiator is the power headroom. James Bryston, Canadian company Bryston chief engineer and owner, explained a super quality amplifier secret. Rule of the third. Any power amplifier has a performance sweet point at 1/3 for max power, where everything is great. For AB class amplifiers, it is a significant challenge, dramatically rising costs going beyond 100 watts due to efficiency issue. 100 watt amplifier sweet point is just 30 watts. If you own 150 watt music power capable speaker system, you need a good 450 watt amplifier. Only with class D amplifier arrival, we can achieve those requirements for a reasonable price. And the second secret mentioned by James Bryston is importance of preamplifier. Very good amplifier requires very good preamplifier circuits to achieve the best performance. Setting the right expectations. If you have 300 watt good amplifier, don't invest in my design. You already have everything you need. If you have 100 to 150 watt power amplifier, your investments will be rewarded and speakers will start to perform like never before. Small size, flexibility to operate near speakers, balanced inputs, low idle power may be considered as extra benefits. Things to avoid. Controlling the main switch during the on-off process. There is a spring-loaded mechanism built in the main switch. It generates kind of loud click noise. People tend to control this process minimizing noise. Don't do that. There are so-called inrush current charging power supply large capacitors in the moment switching on an amplifier. For slow switching, welding process occurs, reducing on-off switch lifetime. A low spring mechanism work for a fast connection. Second, measuring power amplifier at maximum load of 500 watts. Let us remember that music power density is 1/8 of sine wave power density. So, if we take 500 watts and divide by 8, it's 62.5 watts average power. ICEpower125ASX board can dispatch 100 watts, but not 500. It is built with kilowatt-capable components and can deliver 500 watt music performance with confidence, but it cannot dispatch 500 watts sine wave generated heat. Want to measure characteristics of 500 watt? Use swipe generator and modern measurement equipment capable to make all measurements in a couple of seconds. To protect against such scenario, ICEpower designers built in thermal surge, what will blow out in 20 seconds after continuous 500 watt sine wave measurement. Replacement of this component takes a long spare part delivery time and SMD soldering. Don't do that without understanding electronic basics. And support materials. Additional to this video, I made series of small videos explaining the number of above mentioned headlines. There are video explaining balanced input principles and advantages, interview parts with James Bryston, Macintosh and many more. All of them are available on my YouTube channel under the title Story of the Perfect Amplifier. DIY kit installation instructions are available in several languages, including the English language. Taking this opportunity, I would like to thank everyone who has contributed to the project I designed. TC Russert Company engineers for the time invested and passion looking for the optimum solution. Believe me, to make something simple in design and well functioning requires a time-consuming design optimization process. Company ICEpower for technical and startup support. Company Valburg for production setup. And most important, my YouTube channel viewers who largely initiated this project.